Right, as I was trying to sit here and think of an example of what I could do in this program, I was thinking back to my dating days and how it would have been so much easier. I envied the countries that are arranged marriages because, I mean, yeah, you could have some bad luck, get stuck with somebody you don't like, but just think about it. You might get the luck of the draw and be with somebody that you never could have been with in a million years. And then they would feel bad. Anyway, what I thought is we could create a little compatibility program where you can enter two names and then click check compatibility, and it will tell you whether you're compatible or not. Okay, let's try it. So, first thing we'll want to do is create. Now, I'm just going to start out by creating the class with the frame in it. This won't be the main class. There's going to be a main class that's going to build an instance of this compatibility program. And so I'll create this class first, public class, and call it compatibility. With that long of a pause, you think it would have come up with something more exciting than that name. Okay, now again, this isn't going to have a main method because this is going to be a object that's created from the main method and controlled there for this game. And so, what I'm going to do then is just move right to the constructor for the method because I want to do some setup. And remember that the constructor is only there to be executed one time when the program is first created, and it's not to be executed again. So all this setup stuff we can do in this in this constructor method. So public, and it can't return anything, so we don't put anything there. And compatibility, opening, closing parenthesis. And then what I'm going to do, just to kind of keep this a little bit cleaner, is I'm going to create a separate method called create contents or something like that. And this will just be a private method that's not going to return anything. The only reason I do this is just to kind of keep things a little more organized with what's happening in this program. And so all I'm going to do from here is call the create contents method, which will then jump down to here and execute this code here, but then there's only a couple things happening in this method, right? Okay, so kind of what I'm picturing is that we're going to have name one and name two labels and then text boxes. And so I'm going to, again, anything that we want to be able to access for the duration of the time this class is available, we probably want to declare at the class level. So for example, the J label, I'm going to want to declare at the class level, and I'll just call it label. Let's see, I jumped already to the label. We got to set up the frame first, I guess. J frame, and I'll just call this main window, and just set it up first. We're going to want a J label now for the, I'll call it label name one. And then we're going to want another J label for label name two. And then private J text field for text name one. And then a private J text field for text name two. Okay, so we've got our elements, and then we need to have a button. So J button that I'll just call check, which is, or I'll better do button check, which is going to check for these elements. Now, if I try to compile this right now, I guess I need to save it first. But if I try to compile it, it's not going to work because it's not going to recognize any of those symbols. Remember that those are not just built into Java. We have to import the javax.swing.asterisk to get all of those in there. All right, so then after we've remember, this is the declaration of the object, but to actually set them up, we can do that inside the create contents. And so I can say, go in and build the frame. So I can say, let's go set main window. And remember, there's a few different options we have to set, but the first one might be to set the size of this object. And I kind of like the, well, let's go a little bit bigger. Let's do like a 600 by 400. We'll kind of keep that same ratio, but move up another level. So we'll set the size to 600 by 400. And then what else do we need to do? Well, we've got to do a few different things. One is we want to probably set the title. We can set it to something like check your, we'll make it a more of a title, check your compatibility. Wouldn't this save a lot of time to have a little compatibility checker? You just go up, enter it in the computer, check it. If you're not compatible, don't go out. Simple enough. Okay, we're going to go set in the main window. We're going to set the a default close operation so we can actually close it to main window dot exit on close. Remember, that variable belongs not to our class but to the JFrame class. So that's why we have to put this first and then the dot. And then I think the other one we did was to set the what was it? I know we're going to set visible, but there's, set the layout. And that's going to be equal, we'll just use that same flow layout. Okay. And then we don't want to set that to visible. In fact, we won't even set anything to visible until after this. So after we're done creating the contents, then we'll set visible to true. After this whole method executes and we get everything set up, then we can do that. Okay, so we've got that set. And then we want to set up the rest of the elements. So we're going to go to our label. Was it name one? Yeah, label name one. And that's going to be equal to a new JLabel that says enter the first name. How can we say this? Enter the first name sounds like enter your first name, not enter the, you know, enter first name. So we'll just say name number one. Enter name number one. How about that? Okay, so that'll be our label for the first label. The label name two will be enter name number two. And then we can create our text fields. So text name one is going to be a new text J text field. And how many characters do we want to allow for it? Well, let's go back to our 15 and we'll do that. And then text name two is going to be equal to a new J text field of 15 characters as well. And then we have our button. Button, what did I, it was check, right? Equals new J button, and that button is going to say check compatibility. Okay, so I could create even another method here calling adding components, but we'll just go ahead and add them here. So I want to add them to the main window frame, right? So I say go out to the main window frame and add. The first thing we want to add is label name one, right? And then we want to add the text name one so that it has the label and then the text. And then I'll go out to the main window and add the label name two. And then I'll go to the main window and add text name too. And let's just see if that much works. Well, I guess I might as well just add the button. There's only one other thing. It's like, why not do it? Okay, so main window, add, and then we'll add the button check. And we'll see how all of this looks on the form. The only thing we need to do is, now that we've got this class, we need to have another class call it. And so I'll just create... we do get an error with the flow layout. Remember, that wasn't part of this JavaX.swing library. The flow layout is actually part of the java.awt.asterisk library. And now that compiles fine. So now I just need to create another class. And this will be the game driver class. Oops, public class game driver. And this will be the one that has the public main method. So public static void main string args. This is the one that's going to be driving the game, making it all at least get started. So I'll create a new instance of the compatibility and just call it C equals new compatibility. Whoops, opening closing parenthesis. And that will start the game. So I'll go ahead and save this. And I know at this point, this probably seems kind of stupid because it's not really doing much. And truthfully, we could have this be its own main method and run it. But what ends up happening is your main method, in a real honest-to-goodness program, it's not just going to do this. There's going to be lots of other things that's controlling and doing. And so we just want to kind of get in good habits for making these things work right. All right, and I get a null pointer exception when I set the size of the frame. Null pointer exception. Oh, okay. I set up the name for the frame, but I never actually did set up the frame, did I? So I probably need to do that. So I need to set main window equal to a new JFrame. Let's try that. Okay. So we've got enter name 1. Enter name 2, and then we can check the compatibility. Okay, so we need to put something down here. That's one thing that I haven't done is to put something down here to make it so I can print the results. And so I'm going to add one more label. And call it label results. And then I'll build that here. New J label. And it's going to say nothing initially, but I do want to get it added on the form. So it's going to be blank, but it's going to be down below that button. Actually, it'll be to the side of the button because the button's not quite big enough, but we'll worry about that when the time comes. Okay. So now we've got a place to actually print out the results to the user. Now this will be really exciting at this point because it's blank. But there is an element there, you just can't see it. Okay? All right, so in the next part we'll make this actually do something. Sound good? Spencer out.